Have you heard the legend of the magical train that travels around the world on Christmas Eve? Anyone can come aboard, so long as they follow one simple rule. They must atone for the wrong they've done to others by listening to three moral tales. So, will you listen to my tales? You're so cold and hungry. Would you like to ride on my Christmas Express? It's warm in here, and we have delicious treats.
Wait, Hansel! Don't go!
Sorry, Gretel, but we all have our own path to follow. Perhaps we'll meet next year. Don't worry, Gretel. I'm not upset you've tagged along, but I'm afraid you can't leave so easily. You see, this train is designed to help those who've done something bad before Christmas and wish to make it right. You broke a rule by coming aboard without my permission, but you can make this right. I'd like you to take part in three stories which will be told to the passengers aboard my train. Gretel, if you help me by participating in all three tales, I'll let you lead the train. But if you refuse, you won't be able to lead the train, and neither will your brother. He's here as well. I'll give you until midnight. Now, are you ready for an exciting journey? Take this. It shows how much time is left.
Thank you. Eliza and my son Tommy were waiting for me at home. The chief said he'd fire me if I didn't. I couldn't lose my job. I called Eliza to give her the bad news. I heard Tommy cry out and run off. Eliza supported me as usual. She said she'd talk to him. A few hours later, Eliza called me and asked me if I'd seen Tommy. He had run away and had come to find me. I hadn't, and we still can't find him. This is my fault. I hope he's okay.
was writing an essay for class and wanted to decorate with our family photos. I have the best family. Mom, Dad, me, and my future brother. I was really looking forward to that Christmas because I made a cool surprise for them. And said he couldn't make it, I felt so bad for him. I didn't want him to be alone at his work for Christmas, so I decided to surprise him there. Says it's dangerous to go outside because a bear has been wandering around. But I'm not scared. That bear is probably hibernating. I just have to wait for Mom to go to sleep, and then I'll sneak out. Thank you. and I decorated the Christmas tree together. We talked about going out on Christmas Eve to shoot fireworks, but now we can't, because Dad is stuck at work. I don't want Dad to be sad. I'll leave home and visit him instead. Dad warned me that the forest is dangerous. There's bears and wolves and other stuff, but I'm prepared. I brought a flare gun and that will scare all of them. Besides, Dad will be so happy when I surprise him.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Gretel. You're almost finished with the first story, with two more tales ahead. But I am impressed by your sense of purpose and bravery. I'm delighted to see that you've almost rescued the boy. But the trouble is that there's a scary bear in the forest. Aren't you afraid that it'd attack you? What's this? You've run out of flares. Well now, what a grand plot twist. I'm interested to see what you come up with. Thank you.
I didn't listen to all three stories. I thought it was a waste of time. But now, I finally have my own appearance, and I'm going home. Good luck, and goodbye.
You're an interesting young lady, Gretel. You managed to escape such an incredible situation. I'm quite impressed. Well, I hope you and your brother are ready to listen to your second fairy tale. Let me remind you of your time here. It's quickly running out. Meet your second storyteller.
Working on Christmas Eve? What could be worse? I was going to have guests over, but now I am stuck here. Who would come to the archives on Christmas Eve anyway? I suppose they think Santa himself is going to come asking about the local children, I made a shopping list, food, gifts, and entertainment for my guests, but I haven't done any of it. I'll have to spend the whole evening running through town, looking for any open stores, and waiting in long lines. Oh, this girl? Yes, she came in at the end of my workday as I was closing up. I don't have time. Special services will take care of her today. Look, I'll be happy to help her after Christmas.
Barnes. After Mom died, I was sent to live in an orphanage. I hated it. I have a father, but I don't know where he is. On my birthday, I wished to find my dad. Then a miracle happened. I was given a gift Mom had prepared years beforehand. It was a photo of my dad. I escaped from the orphanage and came here. It's been a long journey. I'm certain these archives have information about my father. Christmas is just around the corner. I don't know if they'll help me, but I'm hoping for a Christmas miracle.
It's Christmas Eve, and I finally finished my workday. I still have so much to do. I haven't even started shopping yet. I'm not ready for Christmas at all. Suddenly, this girl appeared before me. She was quite untidy and mumbling to herself. At first, I thought she was just a street urchin, but I think she was searching for someone. I called child services so that poor thing wouldn't have to spend Christmas Eve out on the street. I still have so much to do. I don't have time to help this child.
Thank you. love you.
Thank you.
Well, thank you. What a nice girl. I got to ride this train because I regretted not helping that poor girl. The storyteller asked me to listen to 3 fairy tales, but I was so impatient, I couldn't do it. I was turned into a goose, so I've been waiting for someone to help me. Now my story has a happy ending. I helped that girl find her father. She found a real Christmas miracle. Good luck. Be wise and patient, and I know your story will have a happy ending too.
You've successfully completed 2 stories. I hope you'll walk away with a conclusion, but time's running out. Now you must return to the story you know so well. Good luck.
Come on, sis! One last story to solve! We can do it!
I decided to add a little bit of spice to this story. Everything's mixed up in your house. All the items are in new places and the doors are closed with new locks. Father's spice shop have become completely unfamiliar. You'll have to study everything carefully. Let's see how you cope with this.
Today we're awaiting some special guests, our extended family. Dad's finishing his work at our spice shop early to buy some treats. Mom spent all day in the kitchen. The smell of goodies has filled our house. Mom cooked a fabulous gingerbread house and left it on the table. I thought no one would notice if I nibbled a bit, but I accidentally broke the house. I panicked, but I decided to eat some and hide the rest. Mom was so upset when she couldn't find the gingerbread house. She began scolding my sister Gretel, and I froze. I was so...
dear, Gretel, your time's up. I'm not sure you've managed to complete this story or not. How about we play an exciting game using my rules? If you win, I'll release you and your brother. If not, you'll become a permanent passenger. Your brother will remain a mouse, and you'll be a delightful cat. Do you agree? Why am I asking? Of course you agree. Let's begin. And so, this is the end. Hansel and Gretel reconciled with their mother after the broken gingerbread house. Lily found her lost father and acquired a family. Samuel celebrated Christmas at home, together with his beloved family. Well, it's time for my Enchanted Express to head home. What stories await me in the future? We'll see next Christmas Eve.